Commissioner, it's good to see you in your office. An opportunity for us to catch up. You've been in this appointment for 18 months now. How are you feeling?
Well, it's hard to believe that 18 months have passed. We've been so busy. We've been thoroughly immersed in this territory. There's so much more to see, but we've loved it.
So have you found things to encourage you in the territory and that give you a lot of fulfillment and satisfaction?
Absolutely. Yeah. You know, the best part of our roles as territorial leaders is that we actually get to leave the office. Yeah. And we get to go out and see people on the front line doing great things. And we've seen some wonderful stories of transformation, people being transformed. We've seen corps being transformed, institutions and centers being transformed, and also communities. So the Salvation Army is all about transformation. Yeah. And it's wonderful when we see that the ministry and mission of the Salvation Army is being fulfilled out there. It's the greatest thing that we experience.
I'm really pleased that you're seeing things that really give you a lot of joy. Yes. Are there things that frustrate you as well, and perhaps even have there been disappointments as you've gone around the territory?
I know the diplomatic answer should be that no, all is well. But the truth is there are things that frustrate. It's a huge territory. And because of that, the administration has evolved to become something of a monster. And the consequence of that is that decisions take a long time. We have to go through a lot of processes in order to make things happen. And my bent is to get on with the job. So sometimes that's frustrating. It frustrates me that we're unkind with each other. There was a particular incident during the first 6 months where we threw a television program that some people liked and some people didn't like. I saw that we're not good at communicating our differences in a positive Christian way. I saw that sometimes we can be unkind. That frustrates me.
And you'd like to see that change?
Absolutely. I believe that we should have robust discussion, that we should be cutting edge in terms of discussing whether we want to go one way or the other, but I think we can be kind about it. And that particular incident disturbed me.
Yeah.
We should not be battling with each other. We should be battling against what matters, evil out there.
Oh, I'm really pleased to hear that. I think kindness is sometimes underrated.
Indeed.
Commissioner. Yeah, thank you. One of the ways that we're looking at what's going on around the territory is through the Fit for Mission, which is a kind of review of what we're doing.
Yes.
Now, for those who may be watching who don't know about Fit for Mission, could you explain what it is and perhaps say what you hope it might achieve?
Yes. Fit for Mission is a process in which we are analyzing and evaluating everything that we do, all the systems that we have, in order to make ourselves more efficient in delivering mission. We need to be fit for mission.
Yeah.
And we are doing it in various ways. We basically went to the territory, evaluated it, and discussed where we are and where we want to be in terms of doing mission. And that gap, Fit for Mission, is discussing how do we get from where we are in administration, in delivering mission, to where we want to be. Fit for Mission is that process.
Okay.
One of the key things about Fit for Mission is that it has forced us to think about strategy. It's forced us to think about what is the important things that the Salvation Army should be doing. And we've identified that. We've identified four key areas that we want to strategize and make a priority over the next few years, and we'll be announcing that soon.
Do we know what they are yet? Are they still to be announced, those four
areas? They are still to be announced, but this is an okay way for us to discuss it, and we hope to unpack it a bit more. But it's encapsulated in the word tide.
Right.
The Salvation Army is going to be focusing on four areas. T, transformation, that we want everybody involved in the Salvation Army to understand the reason why we're doing what we're doing is because we believe in transformation.
Yeah.
The second is integration. We have become good at operating in silos, operating in our own little fields. And we've discovered that if we work together, we achieve so much more. And it's easier to focus on the goal. So integration, integrated ministry is going to become a key focus area and is already being affected by the way we do things.
Okay.
The next thing is bottom line for the church, discipleship. The
right.
D is for discipleship. And we believe that God has called us as a church to make disciples. That was Jesus' last words to the church, make disciples.
Yeah.
And that's going to be very important for us. And the final one is about fit for mission. We want to be effective. So T for transformation, I for integration, D for discipleship, and E for effectiveness. Those are the missional priorities of the Salvation Army that we are hoping we're all going to embrace.
And tide comes from William Booth's.
It's a happy coincidence, of course. The process,
those words. Inspiration?
Well, the inspiration came afterwards. Those words came out of a conversation we've had with leaders, with the territory, and we've discovered what the important priorities are. But then when we looked at the words, one genius said, these words spell tide. I thought of diet, you see. But this genius said tide.
Yeah,
and of
tide's
course,
better, I think.
Immediately you get this idea of the tide is now
flowing. Yeah.
I'm touching the wave.
Yeah. And so, it's about going forward, isn't it? It's
exactly.
about movement, which is
indeed.
What the Salvation Army
and
is.
And being carried forward almost by a power outside of ourselves.
Yeah.
And that's what we believe in. We believe that God is behind what we're doing.
Yeah.
So it's a great word.
I like it. I like it. Now, soon after you arrived in this appointment, the High Council met to elect a new general, and you
yes.
were nominated, but you didn't accept the nomination. Could you tell us why that was, Commissioner?
It was a no-brainer, really, because I had just arrived. The territorial leaders before us had been here for 8 months. It would have been extremely strange if, had I been elected, I'd have to move and then the territory would have to face a new leadership change. That was one thing. The other thing is, I didn't feel that this is what God wanted of me. I didn't feel God wanted me to seek to be the general. I felt that God wanted me here. And so it was easy for me to say no.
Yeah, I understand. Commissioner, I do need to ask you, as one of your Facebook friends, one of your many hundreds of Facebook friends, you use social media a lot to communicate who you are, your family, also words of encouragement and what you're doing as a territorial
yes.
commander. And you blog as well, so social media is very important to you.
It is.
So why do you see the value in that?
Okay. I think that one of the things that social media does, it puts us all on the same plane. You know, there's no hierarchy in the social media. And I think that's important. It's my understanding of leadership, that leadership isn't about formalities and hierarchy, but it's about getting alongside people and influencing them. Now, social media for me is that. It enables people to see I'm normal, that I'm approachable, and I think that I've succeeded in that. It helps me to model normality. In other words, that we take time off as a family. I will show them pictures of me lounging at the beach because I want people to understand that we're normal and that it's good to take time off. In fact, some people have confirmed that to me, that they feel easier about taking their days off because they see the TC is doing it. The other thing is, it's a wonderful way to get a quick message out effectively and in a broad way. And then I also want to model that social media can be used responsibly because it's just a tool and it can be abused or it can be used. And I want to make sure that people see that it can be used in a positive way.
And you occasionally put verses of scripture and
yes.
and photographs of where you visited over
That's
weekends.
Right. Yes, I do that.
Becoming very well known for your what's termed selfies and even elfies,
even
where
elfies.
Somebody takes a photo for you.
Yes.
Well, I think that's groundbreaking.
Indeed.
So now, as you go forward in this appointment, Commissioner, what would be your hopes and dreams for this territory? What would you like to see happen here in the UK and Ireland?
There's a lot of wonderful things happening. What I want is for those wonderful things to become the norm all over the place. I'm wanting growth. I'm wanting more soldiers to be made. We've got a lot of people crossing our doors. A lot of them regard us as their faith community, their spiritual home. I want more soldiers because an army needs soldiers. And by that I mean engaged members who understand that they're not there to be pampered, but they're there to be put into the front line. And that can only happen if the Salvation Army looks at itself and asks, how do we need to get more members? So those processes are taking place. I want us to make an impression on society. I want society to be influenced by the Salvation Army. And I'm not only talking about the upper echelons of having the Prime Minister's ear, although I think we need to do a better job of our public statements and our public communication, but also in community, that the Salvation Army is a place where people know, here I will be met by people who understand and who care and who will make a difference. I want us to make a difference in the world. That's why we're here.
I agree. And I think a lot of other people will too. Mm. Thank you very much for your time, Commissioner. Really appreciate it. And I hope that perhaps through this link video, more people will commit to praying for you and for Commissioner Mariana as you go forward in this ministry.
Thank you. And God bless you too.
Thank you.